sports presentation of the NBA. But the bad news is there is no basketball. There is no NBA. The game has been canceled. Ha ha! Happy April Fool's Day, baby! This is the NBA, and we've got a great one in store. Joined in the booth with Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, this is Kevin Harlan. Our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. It's the Orlando Magic facing the Baltimore Barons. A look at the Magic starting group. Paul George is out there with Maladon. Then it's Bamba. Then it's Aaron Gordon. And it's Smith in at the power forward position. Greg, the two words you and I don't like the most in this game, load management. Why do we see more of it now than when you played in the game?
A couple of things. I think sports science has evolved, and I've talked to a ton of coaches about this. The reality is that now they don't determine whether or not a guy's going to play. It's going to be the people that work with the strength and conditioning. They determine if a guy is ready to go. Secondly, I would also say, the contracts now, the investments that teams have in these assets, you want to try to prolong their careers as long as possible. And so I think it's a smart move from an investment standpoint.
Well, you bring up some great points. Now, here's Bamba. And here is Maladon. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
On that one, shouldn't be much debate there.
This is his first free throw of the game. And he knocks down the first one. And he makes both free throws. Here's Ball. The kick out to Porter. Fires for three. It's hauled in by Gordon. And it's Orlando's ball. Pass to Bamba. Back to Gordon. And now just over a minute played here in the first. Short. He's off on that one. And Baltimore going the other way now. Outside Ball. And the officials call him for a 3-second violation. And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for the Magic. George looking over the floor. Good D by Bogdanovich.
I don't think the defense does enough out there to bother him. I think that one's all on him. Just a flat-out miss.
He shoot again. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
And Michael Porter Jr. being drafted was a bit of a high risk, high reward due to the fact that physically he needed to come a long way to be consistent in the NBA. We may be seeing signs that it's going to pay off with huge dividends.
Shoot two.
Free throw good. Porter. Good on both.
Makes it pretty tough on the defense. Who are you going to pick to send to the free throw line? And he's hitting the free throws right now. Form looks good.
here's Melodon. Outside, George. Dishes it to Smith. Three-pointer. George missing again. Here are the Barons.
And the versatility of Paul George's game. Elite defense and rebounding, steals and deflections.
And you think about Paul George moving to several teams, yet still having the impact on both ends of the floor. I think that is a telltale sign that you have an elite talent in Paul George.
And, you know, as he learns the game at this level, he's going to block more shots. Porter has the length and the ability to move his feet.
Throws it up high.
And how sweet a play was that?
As sweet as it gets, an exquisite pass to set up the powerful alley-oop dunk. Now, here's Melodon. D right on him. Shoots. And that one off the back of the rim and in.
And off the schneid here, 1 of 5, but that's a big one.
Pass to Beth. He kicks it to Bogdanovich. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. That one on George.
Well, Bogdanovich being a little bit crafty there, knowing the defense was closing in on him, and drew the contact.
Baltimore shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
Shooting two.
Free throw good, Bogdanovich.
And Bogdanovich has raised a lot of eyebrows with his consistent play over the past couple seasons. He can really be a spark plug for your ball club as he's able to knock down threes and produce points in a hurry.
He hits both from the stripe. And here is Melodon. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, I was able to catch up with the head coach for Baltimore. We talked about the problems Paul George can cause with his defense. Coach told me the sets we run with longer passes, those need to be adjusted. George is a ball hawk and changes how you operate on the perimeter. If there's one thing we know about PG-13 guys, is that he feasts on lazy cross-court passes. Back to you.
Thank you, David. And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter. Shot clock at 5. Here's Melodon. Cranes the three-pointer. Melodon's got 5 points so far.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Ball with it. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. And Theo Melodon picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game.
And now only one away from being in the penalty.
On defense, the Magic. They trail by one. Coming off that loss against the Timberwolves.
Yeah, on the road, you're already a little out of your element. Then the misses from the line become contagious.
Well, it can affect your confidence, not just as the player shooting, but the entire team. So defenses might get a little bit more aggressive, and then you got to think about the next free throw.
Clearly a foul.
On the night, he's gone 2 for 2 at the stripe. It up, and this next one could give them the lead. Monte Morris has checked in for Ball. And that drops, so they now lead by one. Baltimore on offense. Morris looking over the floor. Bogdanovich passes to Bell. Back to Bogdanovich. And it's good off the back of the rim and in.
Great shooting off the pass. Get the feet set. Good balance. Bogdanovich dangerous.
Maladon passes to Gordon. Poked loose. And now Porter pushing it up. No one back to stop him. And finished off by Porter.
And Porter has such great athleticism, able to get up and throw it down.
Now George. There's the pass to Gordon. Five to shoot. Pulls up. Baltimore with the rebound.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Porter, no luck.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
Here's Gordon. Porter with a block. It's good.
Just so smooth pulling up there off the dribble. Porter terrific at being unpredictable and knowing when to take that shot.
Now here's Maladon. 7 points in the game. Outside Gordon. Back to George. Let's go. And he wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron.
Well, that's Paul George's game. Most accurate when somebody's feeding him and he's got his feet set.
Passes to Porter. Back to Bogdanovich. Baltimore needs to get off a shot here. From about 19 feet. And it's off the back rim. No good. The Magic trail by three. Here's Maladon. Good work defensively by Morris. And so it's Porter bringing it up now for the Barons. Pass to Bogdanovich. Back to Porter. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It's going to be on Aaron Gordon. Today, Greg, we see a lot more friendly rivalries. Does that bother you?
Not at all. I mean, people like to say, well, our era had the rivalries were more bitter. I disagree with that. I think guys are every bit as competitive today as they've ever been.
That's good to hear.
Take a break.
They
Take
just
break.
Also have more exposure and opportunity to be around one another. Kids today growing up, they've been playing against each other since the fifth, sixth grade in national tournaments. When we played, we didn't get to see the other top players around the country. So I think that was one reason why you didn't have a closeness with guys that unless you were on the same team.
So both teams making some changes here. And so he makes both from the line. The Magic trail by five. Here's McLaughlin. Kicks it to Cook. Outside Gordon. Vucevic against Portis. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. And here's a look at some numbers for him. First trip to the line for him here.
And the free throw line was a problem spot for him in their last game. Really struggled up there.
First free throw is good. Baltimore making a switch here. Silva's checked in.
Both free throws good for Vucevic. Baltimore leading by three. Down low, here's Portis. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
And their post play has been really solid right off the bat.
Here's McLaughlin.
That's a whistle he did not want to hear. His second foul, and we're not even out of the first quarter.
The Magic have been excellent at the free throw line here today, a flawless 6 for 6. Good on that one. And no good on the second free throw, so he goes 0-for-2 there. Morris dishes to Evans. Morris outside. Pass to Roby. Shot clock at 6. Out to Morris. From downtown, Morris with the bucket. And the Barons lead by 8.
That's just a lapse right there. No matter what, somebody has to be there and get a hand up in the shooter's face.
So it's Orlando now. Cook looking it over. High arcing shot, and Silva pulls it down. Baltimore on offense. They're on a 13-4 run right now, and the shot is good. And now a 10-point Barron lead.
Yeah, they have gone full throttle from the opening tip, showing no signs of letting up.
Yeah, you wondered if they would take some time to find their A game. They did it at jump ball. They've been awesome tonight.
Here's McLaughlin. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Got a piece of it, and they're able to recover. And it's Evans with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Barons. And there's Morris. That's good on the assist by Evans. Morris has got his third basket of the night.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Here's McLaughlin, and the rejection by Evans. Out of bounds as Orlando keeps possession. Goran Dragic has checked in for Orlando. Bounce pass, Smith shoots. Once again off the mark, Orlando.
Yeah, that miss might stick with them for a little while. That's kind of a shoot-around jumper if I've ever seen it.
Their play on both ends has been superb. We'll see if they can maintain the momentum.
Like tonight, that all the hustle plays have meant so much to this team. Now just sustain some of that energy and keep comfortable.
Time call here. The Magic decide to talk it over. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Take a look out east. Look at Orlando. They're trying to get in the playoffs here. If they stay the course, they will. And of course, the Barons, 7 games back.
And I think for the Magic, they've fulfilled a lot of the promise they showed coming into the season. But they just haven't taken that next leap forward so many thought they might.
They still had enough players take positive steps forward to call this season a success. Maybe they're not at the top of the standings where they'd hope they'd be, but they're in really good position in terms of the playoff picture.
Agic against Morris. He dishes it to Evans.
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Yeah, if you walked in at any point during this game to watch 5 minutes of play, one team played harder. We know who that was.
So it's Orlando now, following the bucket by Baltimore. Here's McLaughlin, five on the clock. A floater, happy to see that one go in for his second make in five attempts. A minute 50 left to play here in the first. Morris against Dragic. Morris passes to Roby. That's in, and he found his range with that one. Now one for two.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
Outside Dragic. It's blocked.
Team's rebounding is a great measure of its energy, and theirs has been terrific here in the first quarter.
Yeah, drawing fouls and making them pay at the line.
Baltimore shooting their seventh and eighth free throw attempts for the game right here.
Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. The Magic making a switch here. Amba's checked in. And both free throws good for Evans.
And trailing here in the early going, too many careless fouls, and they're giving up a lot of trips to the line.
Inside, here's Vucevic, and again it's Orlando converting.
Now, some guys have a hard time finding their teammates in those possessions. Dragic is always looking the dish to get it to the open man.
Here's Morris, and a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. For Baltimore, they have been at their finest form at the free throw line tonight. Eight attempts, eight makes.
Take a break. Two shots.
Free throw good for Morris. Both shots good from the stripe. 52 seconds left in the first quarter. The Magic trail by 15. Dragic the pass to Cook. Here's Vucevic. He kicks to Bamba. Down to five on the shot clock. And the dunk by Bamba.
And how about the 9'6" standing reach Bamba has? I mean, it's unguardable this close. Dunks it with such ease.
Morris passes to Portis. Kicks it out to Evans. Baltimore moving that ball around. And the wide open shot from Morris. Again, the miss by Baltimore. Here is Cook. No points in the game yet for him. To the paint. And Vucevic with the basket on the assist by Dragic. Dragic has got his third assist on the night. And so it's Baltimore holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to take a break. The defensive work they've done against Paul George has been a big factor. He hasn't done anywhere near the kind of damage we expected. We'll get right back to the action when we return. So far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen so far, guys, from the Barons.
Well, this is the edge that great rim protection can give you.
Yeah, you can't be careless with your shot selection out there because some of them are getting thrown back.
Here's Dragic. This is how the floor looks for the Magic starting the second. They've got Mohamed Bamba. He's out there with Paul George. Vucevic is out there with Dragic. And it's McLaughlin in at the two spot. And slam dunk by Vucevic.
And using every bit of that large frame for the exclamation point, Vucevic, a force around the rim.
Now, here is Morris. Outside Portis. Here's Silva, defended by George. Six on the shot clock. The pass to Silva. Here's the three. Goran Dragic grabs the board.
Well, the D doesn't seem to be too worried about him from three-point range, and he shows us why still. I expect him to make one of those.
I love the advantage he has from a speed standpoint. Does a great job of creating separation for that shot.
Greg, one of your former teammates, John Starks, would get under a guy's skin on the court. He's like a nuisance, but really opposite off the floor, away from the game.
I tell you, Kev, John's got a heart of gold, and anybody that knows him is going to be a fan of the person. John is as good a friend as I can ever recall having.
You wonder if Paul George finally has a situation here where he could show why he's an elite player, why he's an all-star, but to pay off how hungry he is to prove it with a late postseason run.
Here's McLaughlin. He's covered by Ball. Passes it to McLaughlin. Tipped away. And it's Baltimore on the break. Here's Roby. Can't hit that one. Dragic with some nice D. And it's Dragic with the ball for Orlando. They haven't allowed any points in the second quarter. Shot clock at five. Pass to McLaughlin. Trying to find Vucevic. Gets it to him. Excellent D there from Ball. The Barons come into this one after the win against the Knights. Bogdanovich finds Ball. And here's Bell. Right side, Portis. Here's Roby. It's hauled in by George. Outside, Dragic. Pass to Bamba. Outside, Dragic. The call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Even though he's one of the smallest guys right now on the floor, Dragic knows how to play big when he gets down low.
For Orlando, they have gone 7 of 9 from the free throw line tonight. First one drops.
Well, when it comes to free throws, Dragic is just money from the line.
Aladon's checked in for Jordan McLaughlin. And Goran Dragic drops them both.
They've hit every one of their free throws here in the second quarter. Very important when you're trailing.
Vucevic with the block.
Well timed by Vucevic. Not a center who piles up blocks, but this guy picks his spot.
And denied. He sends it right off the glass. And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. And the officials will call the illegal screen right there.
Well, aside from that possession, they've done a pretty good job of keeping the turnovers way down this game.
The Magic trail by 4. From deep, George. Here's Bamba. Lays it up and banks it in.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
Ball kicks to Cousins. The pass to Bogdanovich. To stop the drought. Again, the miss by Baltimore. And it's Orlando's ball. They haven't allowed any points in the second quarter. And it's George missing. Baltimore with the ball. Nothing offensively yet from them in the second quarter.
And at 6'10", Porter is a threat to score inside, which is why the defense is trying to rough him up a bit.
This is his third trip to the free throw line.
Michael Porter taking 2 shots.
Shooting 2.
Free throw good. Porter. Aaron Gordon is checking in for Orlando. And Porter drops them both. Greg, if you're a small market team, how do you convince stars that you've drafted and developed to stay and re-sign?
It's a great question, Kevin. I actually think in a lot of ways it's easier today because you can be box office. You can be a superstar in a small market and have the name recognition because of the era we play in. And so I think the biggest way to keep them there is to build a championship caliber team around them. I think that is your saving grace. If you can prove to them that you can build a championship caliber team, I don't really think that there is a reason to want to leave.
That's a solid blueprint.
That's what he gives you, a big-time presence on the glass.
And you know what, Greg? Once he gets his hands on it, he's not even thinking about kicking it out.
Oh, his competitiveness right now is why the teammates love him.
And here's Bogdanovich for 3. The shot, no good. And Orlando will come the other way. George against Bogdanovich. And Bogdanovich picks up the foul. That's foul number 2 for him.
Yeah, clearly struggling here with the foul. Still early. And just one more will put him over the limit.
Outside Gordon. Pass to Melodon. Dish now to George.
An active player who just takes pride in his defense. Porter is solid at contesting shots with that reach.
It's tipped. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by George.
Great energy on the deflection and a good job disrupting their offense.
Yeah, appreciate the work right now on the defensive end.
They get a hand on it. Ball with it. George picks him up. Clock at 6. Pass to Bell. Over Melodon. Orlando grabs the miss. Bamba's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Porter against Gordon. And looks like the illegal pick was set. Yep, that's right. That'll get their attention.
When a pick like that is questionable and creates that much of an advantage for the offense, you have to
to blow the whistle.
Yeah, a quick little lean like that is going to get the ref's attention. Foul call.
Outside ball. Outside Porter. Here's Cousins. Again, the miss by Baltimore.
Well, that's a shot they want just about on every possession if they can get it. He doesn't make them all, but still very much a high percentage look.
Now, here's Melodon. He has seven. That's going to be out of bounds. The Magic will retain possession. Now a chance to examine the rebounding numbers over the past month for him.
And those are some numbers that he can't be happy about. His rebounding totals have taken a dip over the past few months. He's got to get back to giving the kind of effort on the boards we were seeing from him earlier.
Bamba passes to Gordon. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. LaMelo Ball picks one up.
And there's no question that Gordon is a talented player, and it's clear he wants to be a star in this league.
For Orlando, they have shot 9 of 11 at the free throw line.
And it's been an average year, really, at the free throw line for this group, only around 75%.
That free throw good from Gordon Evans. He's checked in for Baltimore. And a switcher also for Orlando. Smith checked in for Vucevic. It's tied up with that one. Here's Ball. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Dishes it to Porter. That's tipped. Gordon with it. Now guarded by Porter. Here's George. And the rejection by Evans. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Evans. The Magic making a switch here. Cooks checked in. On defense, Baltimore. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. But they get it back. Bamba kicks to Cook. Here's Melodon. The Magic again can't hit.
And I think that one could have easily have fallen for him.
And Evans throws it down hard.
Porter Jr. moving the ball well. Nice to have a wing player help to be a facilitator.
And it's the Magic's ball. They're on a 13-4 run. Melodon passes to Smith. Pass to Melodon. With a block. Out of bounds as Orlando keeps possession. Here's Bamba. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. Bamba's got it all tied up now for Orlando. And here's Ball. He'll bring it up for Baltimore. The pass to Cousins. And the three off target. Basket here gets them back in front.
And it's been a long time coming, partner.
Gordon, the pass to Melodon. A pass to Gordon. It's tipped. It's stolen by Bell. And here we go. Fast break. Evans has got it. Drops in the tray off the fast break. Evans has got 11 points.
Many times you don't like that shot selection, but sometimes when you're just feeling it in transition, when no one's on you, great shot there.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's his first trip to the line. Quinn. Two shots. first free throw is good.
You're having a lot of success from the line here in the second quarter.
Baltimore making a switch here. Silva's checked in. That's also good. So he hits both free throws. Baltimore with the ball. Outside, Porter. Here's Silva. Covered by Bamba. Back to Porter. Bamba with the block.
The main weapon in Bamba's attack, the slender long arms he possesses, helps him block lots of shots.
Here are the Barons. They trail by one. Outside, Porter. Poked away. And Smith with a clear path to the hoop. A shot off that time. Evans with some nice deep.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
To the middle. And Cousins throws it down.
That's power from DeMarcus Cousins.
Here is Cook. Kicks to Smith. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. And he's got his first free throw of the game. The free throw drops for Smith. And some changes here for the Barons. Bobby Portis has checked in for Cousins. And Morris subbed in for Ball. Jordan McLaughlin's checked in for the Magic. Smith hits them both. So it's the Barons now. Now, here is Morris. 9 points in the game so far, and it's blocked by Gordon.
No, I wouldn't test Gordon. With that vertical and length, please try someone else.
And Michael Porter is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line.
Oh no, he's the last guy you want to put on the line. You can just about book the points every time he steps up there.
Good from Cook.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
Baltimore making a switch here. Roby's checked in. That one falls, so he hits both of them.
And it took them a while to find their touch at the line, but they have been red hot here in the second quarter.
Morris outside. Shot clock at 6. Passes it to Evans. Rebound by the Magic. Bamba's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. Jacks up a 3. Sinks the 3-pointer. McLaughlin's got the lead up to 6 now for the Magic.
He's going to punish you if you leave him open. He's more than willing to take the open 3 when he's got it.
Morris outside. Can they get it? And they call the foul. So he's got the and one chance here to make it a 3-point play.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
shot.
Magic leading by three. Pass to Gordon, and it's Gordon finishing it off.
Out of nowhere, Gordon just soaring in there, and that athleticism carries him straight to the hoop.
Morris outside. It's Portis atop the key. Back to Morris. The teardrop falls in. Morris has got 14 points for the game.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Cook dishes to Gordon. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
If they stay this hot from the line, there's a good chance they'll hang on to that lead. They're at about 90% for the game.
He'll take his third and fourth free throw shots of the game right here.
And, of course, we'd all like to see his percentage at the line improve, but he just does not have the touch right now. He's in the 60s.
And he makes the first.
Well, it's interesting to watch him because he's putting his body on the line to get to the line. We didn't see this during the first quarter, but he's making up for it here.
Goran Dragic has checked in for Quinn Cook. He hits one and misses one, each at the line. Baltimore trails by four. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
This is his second trip to the line in this one.
Two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And that one falls for Evans. And both free throws good for Evans.
A great player on a great roll at the charity stripe. The D has got to be careful about being too aggressive on him and sending him back for freebies.
Now here is Smith. Back to Dragic. Got a piece of it. And stolen by Portis. And here we go. Roby can't hit. Orlando leading. Outside Dragic. Pass to Smith. He kicks it to Gordon. To Dragic. Just five to shoot. Shoots over Portis. And so it looks like the Magic will retain possession here. Vucevic checked in for Mohamed Bamba. There's 45 seconds left to play in the first half. And Vucevic kicks to Gordon. Just five on the clock. McLaughlin, the pass to Dragic. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Well, just a really confident play from Dragic to get the foul while he's taking that shot attempt.
He's gone two for two at the line so far. free throw drop for Goran Dragic.
And they've done a better job at the line this quarter. They've got that free throw percentage up to almost 90%.
And the Barons making a change here. Bogdanovich has checked in. Both free throws good from Dragic. 32 seconds left in the first half. To the inside, Evans. It's in, and he's a very efficient 5 for 6 on the game. There's 25 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Knocked loose. It's stolen by Morris. To the wing on the left. Left side, Portis. Feeds to Evans. That ties the game. Evans has got 17 now.
How about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
And that'll do it for the first half. Game time. And we'll be back right after halftime to get the third quarter underway.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, folks, welcome back. Ernie Johnson alongside the Jet. That's Kenny Smith. The Diesel, that's Shaquille O'Neal. A lot of big-time action so far in this one. Looking at the Barons, Kenny, how'd you see it?
Well, one area where they have had the upper hand is scoring off the bench. When the second unit guys have come in, they brought a lot of energy with them. And that's what you need from your reserves, energy. And they gave a lot of energy and a big jump.
Looking at Orlando, Shaq, your thoughts?
I think they're playing defense with their hands instead of their feet. Too many times they've been caught reaching and they paid the price. These guys giving up way too many free throws. They need to stop sending guys to the line. Come on.
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side.
My brother.
First half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. And here is Maladon. We've got Ball. DeMarcus Cousins out there with Evans. Then there's Bogdanovich. And it's Bell in at the five. Roman the paint. The shot by George. Wide open. From outside, off the mark.
Well, that's a shot right there. He's going to hit 9 times out of 10. We just saw the 10% he doesn't make.
A tremendous mobile one block that we had to see again. Great send back.
The defensive awareness, the timing, when you have to face a defender that can reject you like that, it can alter your approach.
And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for the Magic. On the court for Orlando. Gordon out there with Smith. Then there's Maladon. Then it's Bamba. And it's George in at the two. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. Bamba's got it going here in the start of the second half. The first points in the third quarter for the Magic. Ball with it. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. A three from Bogdanovich. Rebound by the Magic. Maladon's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. On the wing, George. That doesn't go either for George.
The third quarter has not started well. Just 1 of 4.
And it's denied. Second half of basketball. Just over a minute played so far. A three, and it's George again missing.
It's almost like he's trying to make things hard on himself. You know, he's just got to slow the game down, try to get some easy ones.
Here's Bogdanovich, and he's finally able to knock one down. Bogdanovich has got the game tied up here for the Barons. Over a minute and a half into the third quarter of action. Maladon passes to George. here's Melodon. Five on the clock. Baltimore with the rebound. And here's the fast break. Ball leading the way. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time. The whistle blowing. He's had four chances at the line. Made them all.
At the line for two.
And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. And both free throws, good for Evans. Into the third we go, 2 minutes in now. Outside, George. Gordon deciding where to go with it. Back to George. Terrific assist, a nice finish. Solid play all around.
And Paul George finding some ways now to be effective on the inside.
Outside, Bogdanovich. Back to Ball. And Ball slams it in.
And sometimes as a point guard, you gotta take things into your own hands.
Yeah, right. It's okay to be selfish when you have a chance like that.
Well, if he's calling his own number, there's a reason for it. There you respect the decision-making from him out there.
And that one's good, George.
Paul George is aggressive. Look at his eyes right now, focused on scoring, and he sees the open path and gets right there.
They swipe it. Here's Melodon. And then Melodon with the dunk.
And that's up-tempo basketball at its best. So much easier to operate in the open court when a steal triggers the break.
Now, here's Ball. Here's Cousins. Rebound by Smith. Smith's got four rebounds now tonight. Their offense has been great here.
Yeah, the ball movement has been terrific, and they've kept the defense off balance.
If you told me this was the kind of game he was going to have, I would not have expected them to be in front right now.
And you could see him give a little nod and then just burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
A pair of teammates, Greg, with a terrific feel for each other. Now a timeout called by Orlando.
Yeah, and his shot selection, iffy at best tonight. A lot of forced contested shots this game. He'll be lucky if he just gets a talking to here instead of a ticket to the bench.
Bamba kicks to Smith. Here's Melodon. 11 points in the game. Tries again. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. The pass to Bell. Rebound by Smith. Smith's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. He dishes it to George. Over Bogdanovich. A nice shot by George. George has got 6 points in the quarter.
Well, that's a needle in a haystack shot right there. You're not going to hit that one all that often.
Baltimore moving that ball around. Up top, Porter, defended by Gordon.
More good work on the glass there. When it's all said and done, I think rebounding might tell the story in this game.
Now, here's Melodon. George with the bucket.
Well, the defense very attentive to him in the first quarter, but he's finally gotten loose in the second and making them pay.
Outside, Bogdanovich. Porter against Gordon. Back to Bogdanovich. The kick out to Porter. Six to shoot, and it's ball in the corner. And it's going to be out of bounds. Baltimore will retain possession. Vucevic checked in for the Magic. Quinn Cook comes in for Gordon. Cousins finds Ball. It's Bogdanovich on the wing. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball. Bogdanovich has got nine.
And Bogdanovich needs very little room. The defense better stay more attached.
Bamba dishes to George. And he finishes nicely on the layup. 18 points for Paul George.
Boy, has he put his foot on the pedal here this quarter. He's doing a terrific job in terms of leading their offense.
Ball no good. Magic leading by four. Right side, George. Baltimore with the rebound. Ball's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Here's Porter, banked in off the glass. He's got 12.
Well, you know, Porter can expect this. Defenses are going to try to be physical with him, try to get in his head.
Passes it to Melodon. Here is Cook, guarded by Porter. Pass to Melodon. Six on the shot clock. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. This is his third trip to the free throw line in the game.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he can't get the first one. He hits the second from the line. Now, Ball. Oh, Porter in position. That shot is off. George with the defensive effort.
And the shots just continue to say no in terms of falling.
Now, here's Melodon. He's got 12. Shot clock at five. Lets the three fly. Connects from three-point range. Melodon's got the lead up to six now for the Magic.
Well, that equals his three-point total from the first half. He had one before the break, and that's his first three of this half.
Now, here is Morris. He's got 14. He is 3 for 3 from the free throw line.
Monte Morris taking two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Orlando making some changes. Jordan McLaughlin comes in for Melodon. And it's Dragic in for Cook. And Morris drops them both.
And even though they're down, they are putting on a show at the free throw line.
And here's George. He'll bring it up for the Magic. Four-point game. Porter with a block. Ball with a wide-open look. Good on the three-point shot. Ball's got 5 points now this quarter.
Just reliable, guys. He's just always trying to make the right play.
And here's Dragic. Outside, George. It's rebounded by Portis. Guys, some great passing from him.
Yeah, everybody's touching it, and you're starting to see the assists pile up because the rhythm is on display offensively.
A great competitive game so far.
And from the look of it, this one could go right down to the wire.
Here's Dragic, following the basket by LaMelo Ball. George passes to Vucevic. Kicks it to Bamba. Dragic with a wide open look. Up the live Orlando. Vucevic. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
You know, in a seven-footer that can play the entire court, Vucevic is a tough cover because of that versatility.
These are his third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
Shooting two.
Free throw drops for Vucevic. And the Barons making a change here. Silva's checked in. And both free throws good for Vucevic. Here's Morris. 16 points for him. Dragic comes with the double team. And a wide open look for Portis. Off target from outside.
Ooh, he missed an easy chance to put some points on the board. He won't get a much better look at that kind of shot again here probably tonight.
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there, sure. Here's Morris. The Magic getting the bucket. Portis kicks to Morris, and it's Dragic with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Jordan Bell's checked in for Baltimore.
Jordan Bell.
Dragic against Morris. Outside Portis. Again, the miss by Baltimore.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage pay.
And George, here we go. Here's Vucevic. That shot off. And the Barons the other way now. Morris inside. He's guarded by Dragic.
Well, a menace in the paint. Once Jordan Bell establishes some position down there, it puts the defense in a tough spot.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Jordan Bell. Two shots.
A free throw drops for Bell.
Well, Bell offers up something at the big man position in terms of his activity that's very unique.
And so Bell nails both of them. Orlando leading. George with the ball. He's got 18. Here's Vucevic. No luck, they battled on the glass but couldn't knock it down. Porter against George. Here is Porter. 12 points for him. He's made all six of his tries at the line so far. And he knocks down the first one. No good on the second free throw.
He was able to tie it up, but he has to be disappointed that he could not give his team the lead.
Now Dragic outside. George. No good with the triple.
And when you can't get anything to fall, it definitely gets in your head.
Especially if you're a player that doesn't get a lot of shot attempts. But otherwise, the mindset is, I just got to get the next one to go. And you don't want to put that much pressure on yourself.
And boy, he's really in a groove. Dominant performance last game. Same thing this time out.
Seems to be nobody standing in his way. No roadblocks for him to get to his spot, capitalize, and continue to be aggressive.
And yes, it's good.
Yeah, I didn't think there was a pass available there for Paul George, but he spots that small crease, he fires the ball through it, and he gets it to his open man.
Now, here is Morris. He's got 16. Porter finds Portis. Baltimore moving that ball around, and he makes that one. Morris has got 18 points in the game.
So far, he's a can't-miss player, a superb scorer who plays to his strength.
Porter against George. There's 53 seconds left to play in the third. Here's Bamba. In it goes for the eighth time in 10 tries.
And it's nice to see Bamba finding his groove. When he's in sync, he feels like he can make any shot.
Inside, Bell. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
And credit the screen for giving him the space he needed to get to the rim.
For sure, GA allows him to come in with the sledgehammer.
Yeah, well, it's settled for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that.
And it's blocked. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Portis. Evans, he's checked in for Ball. And the Magic making a change here as well. Gordon's checked in. Vucevic against Bell. Launches a three. Morris with the rebound. And so it's Morris with it. He'll bring it up for Baltimore. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Porter looking it over. Bamba with the block. Three quarters of play in a close game here. Barons lead by two. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. Competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number four. Our fourth quarter action underway, presented by Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups. On the floor for Baltimore, they've got Bell. Michael Porter's out there with Bobby Portis. Then there's Monte Morris. And it's Evans in at the two. Pass to Gordon. Baltimore with the rebound.
Yeah, and that was lining up to be a huge alley-oop, but they just couldn't quite connect.
Yeah, you can see when it's that close, players react. You just, oh, man, we just missed that one. Maybe they'll get another chance at it.
Here's McLaughlin. Pass to Smith. Morris against Dragic. Lock at six. And right on target with the swish.
Phenomenal shot by Dragic there that left the D feeling helpless on the possession.
To the paint. And finished off by Porter.
Going to the rack with energy. And the D afraid to cut him off.
Yeah, gotta chalk that one up to some shaky defending.
There's some ways to get your coach's attention, and that draws the coaching staff's ire.
And so here's Orlando following the bucket by Baltimore.
This feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
And it's out of bounds. The Barons able to retain possession here. DeMarcus Cousins is checked in for Baltimore. Bogdan Bogdanovic comes in for Michael Porter. And the Magic making a change here as well. Quinn Cook's checked in for Goran Dragic. Final quarter of play, about a minute and a half off the clock into it.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact.
At the line for Baltimore, Monte Morris. At the line for two.
First one falls for him. And the Barons making a change here. Porter's checked in. Aladon's checked in for the Magic. And Morris drops them both.
And his work at the free throw line has been terrific tonight, making the most of his chances.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Cook, the pass to Vucevic. Here is Cook for three. The shot, no good. Morris into the lane. That ball, nice feed that time from Bogdanovic. Morris has got 22.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Now here's Vucevic. Bell with the block.
Timing by the athletic big man. Bell outstanding at getting up quickly for the rejection.
Porter dishes to Morris. Outside, Bogdanovic. And the foul on Jordan Bell. That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
That's his fourth personal foul.
The Magic trail by eight. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. Down low. Here's Vucevic. The Magic again can't hit. Here are the Barons. A great fourth quarter, just giving up 2 points. Doubled by Smith. Morris kicks to Bogdanovic. It's blocked. Here is Cook. That one, no good. Good D by Bell. Baltimore leading by eight. Bogdanovic looking around. Porter trying to free himself up. And it's Bogdanovic again missing. Out to the right wing. Outside Gordon to end the cold streak. They get it back. Gordon's gone 1 of 6 shooting so far. Here's Porter. Lays it up off the glass. Porter's got 19 points.
And Porter's height and length around the basket's going to help him create opportunities to score.
Time call here. The Magic decide to talk it over.
And coach can't be happy, and I think I know why. Their defense putting up no resistance inside.
No, they're not preventing them from scoring, and if you can get to a high efficiency shot on the floor, and that's the paint, you just keep going.
Sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Hey guys, I had a chance to find out what Steve Clifford talked about with his players.
He is not happy with the turnover.
He said we have got to get some shots. It's as simple as that, guys. Play smart and value the basketball. We'll see if the message sunk in, Kevin.
Hammers the alley-oop through.
I think those are the exact shots that the coaching staff wants Bell to be taking, a smart offensive player who really knows his strengths.
Here is Cook. Here's Bogdanović. And Bogdanović throws it down.
Boy, you have to be impressed with the offensive production. They have got it firing on all cylinders.
I mean, this team is just dangerous. Right now, every shot that they're putting up feels like it's going in.
Here's Maladon. Following the score by the Barons. Four on the clock. To stop the run. Porter with a block. And he gets it back. Baltimore leading by 14. And finished off by Porter.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Coaching staff probably most proud of the effort of this team on both ends of the floor here tonight.
To the paint, and it's Gordon finishing it off.
And maybe that'll trigger them. Impossible not to get pumped up after that.
Yeah, well, you can see the immediate reaction of the guys on the bench. They are pumped up. Now, here's Bogdanović. Porter passes to Morris. The kick out to Porter. And Cousins throws it down.
I mean, one guy who's still dominating the inside, DeMarcus Cousins, a great rebounder and a great scorer. That time, a second chance, cashing in.
Here is Cook, and stolen by Bogdanović. And it's Orlando with the rebound. With Samart. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
All the officials are all over that one.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That's good from Cook. So he hits one of two from the stripe. Greg, we are in an era of positionless basketball. And we know the All-Star game now has a two backcourt, three front court position as opposed to two guards, two forwards, and a center when you're voting. Should they get rid of those designations entirely?
I tell you what, I think you could make a strong case for that. When you go back to last season, many felt Jimmy Butler got
starting spot. I think, listen, this is the fans' vote. Why not the five top vote getters? I don't care if they're four guards. If the five players that the fans want to see the most play a certain position, then so be it. You know, they're not going to play all 48 minutes. You're still going to have your seven other spots to kind of balance out the roster. I say just let the fans tell you the five they want to see, and let's go play.
Here's Morris, following the score by Aaron Gordon. Here's Porter. Orlando grabs the miss. Vucevic has got 11 rebounds in the game. Maladon passes to Smith. Oh, and he plucks it off the glass. Wow. Cousins dishes to Morris. And there's the pass to Bell. He kicks it to Bogdanović. Again, the miss by Baltimore.
Well, if he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
Here's Maladon, and the rejection by Cousins. Morris against Smith. Morris with the bucket. Morris has got six here in this quarter.
He has created some terrific opportunities for himself and really made the most of them.
To the inside. And with that shot, the Baron lead is cut back down to 13 points, and that one coming from Vucevic.
Always a battle when you're up against Vucevic. His soft touch helps him convert inside.
Now, here is Morris. And for three, Bell. They get it again. And then Cousins with the dunk.
Scraping and clawing, doing everything he can to grow that lead.
Emphatic on the putback stuff.
Team's having a tough time containing him, attacking all the way there.
And Orlando has possession. Following the bucket by Baltimore. Maladon passes to Vucevic. Clock at four. Pulls it up. And the jumper is on the mark. Now, here is Morris. It's Bogdanović on the wing. Passes to Bell. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
I can't get too physical with Bell. That's only going to get you in a little bit of trouble.
Shooting for Jordan Bells. Jordan Bell. Two shots.
First free throw is good. Ball's checked in for Baltimore. And the Magic making a change here as well. George is checked in. And so Bell nails both of them.
Yeah, sometimes in a game you settle a little bit before settling in, and right now I think he's a big factor in how they're getting to the line.
Shot from the top of the key. No good on the shot, a bit long that time.
That might not be the shot they want him taking, even with the D backing off.
Here's Bogdanović, and the rejection by Smith. And here is Maladon. They get a hand on it. And now Ball pushing it up. No one back to stop him.
Dell doing a great job. Just impact defensive plays.
The Magic trailed by 17. Outside, George. Rebounded by Bell. Bell's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. And Theo Maladon picks up the foul. That's foul number two for him. Ball with it. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. And so he's picked up his final foul, and he will sit for the rest of this game. Bamba is checked in for the Magic.
Taking two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. Ball hits them both. And here's George. He'll bring it up for the Magic. Trailing by 19. And stolen by Bogdanovich. Outside ball. Back to Bogdanovich. Oh, Porter in position.
And Porter right now has it going. And I wonder defensively, are they going to make an adjustment?
The Magic trail by 21. 1:52 left in the fourth. Pass to Maladon. No good. They had a chance to end the run there. Baltimore leading by 21. To the middle, the 10-footer. Cousins. Bell, the second chance points on the tip in. Bell's got 12 points in just the second half.
And as we head to the final buzzer here, a crushing blowout, big time dominance, and this will go in the record books as a gouty win for Baltimore.
As one-sided as it gets today, you know, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, it's hard to think of what didn't go right for them. Game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was just on target.
And you can mark this one down in the W column. It'll mark their 23rd of the season.
And with the win approaching, they'll take the first game here of two that they'll play against this team. Nice to get that first one out of the way and set the tone.
Greg, it's pretty typical for players of the past to talk about current players and say, they may have struggled had they played when I played. What do you think of that line of thinking?
You know, I just don't agree with that. And I think we all do that. We all feel like our era was the best. I had the same thoughts being passed my way when I first came into the league.
I'm sure.
The reality is, these guys work just as hard as guys worked back in our era. They just have more understanding of what their value is. And in a lot of ways, they've got more courage to speak out because, you know, let's face it, they're more of a bullseye on their back in today's era with social media than we've ever seen before.
That is true.
And credit the screen for giving him the space he needed to get to the rim.
For sure, GA allows him to come in with the sledgehammer.
Yeah, well, I settle for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that.
Now, here is Martin. Shot clock at 6. Outside ball. Jacks up a 3. No good there. So Orlando will take it the other way. The shot is good by McCray.
That's the kind of passing you want there. Work the ball around. Keep it moving. Try to get an assist on every bucket.
Outside ball. So it's Baltimore with the win. And the outcome of this one was never in doubt.
And boy, they really put in a supreme effort. It just felt like once they had that lead and it was comfortable, they were not going to relinquish it.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. See you next time.